some new stuff today. Twitch stream stuff. Hopefully this all works. I got the chat pinned. Mouse is hovering over it. Cool. Yeah, so back into VR, doing VR stuff. It was too stormy today, so I couldn't get over to my garage to paint out there. So that's what I'm doing today. And we're on season 27, episode 12, Bob Rogers. We'll see how it goes.
One that will, it'll certainly excite you. We'll start with a little phthalo blue. It's a beautiful, beautiful blue. I love it. I think it's one of the nicest colors that we have. Let's put a little in the 2-inch brush. Let's go up in here.
Oh, yeah. Gotta do some prep work first. So let's do that. I'll open this guy. It can get pretty small. That's nice. First, looks like this is a black canvas. Gesso trees and then some highlights and then some liquid clear, but I don't think there's liquid clear in this app.
There's not a lot of paint on the brush, and I'm just going to start and just make my little crisscross strokes as usual.
Reparation. Laser Off's really good for branches. It just shakes everywhere. It's pretty good. That's about... I look at it, that's about all it was.
And paint right over this. And fantastic.
All right. This is
things will happen. Look at that. Already, it looks like the sky is showing right through the trees. And this is one of the neatest effects. And it's not limited to this. You can do anything with this gesso. There. And where the canvas is dark, I've used a lighter gesso. And vice versa. Look at there. See, already we have a basic background in and done. Let's see, well, I got that blue on my brush. I'm going to add a little more of the Prussian blue because it's stronger. It'll go right over the top. And the corners are going to darken a little with Prussian blue. Prussian blue is much stronger, much deeper. See there? There we go. Just the corners
up.
And that in turn will make this look brighter. If you make this darker, this gets lighter. Now, we've got Prussian blue in the brush. I'll just sort of rub a little of that right here on the canvas. And I know you can't see anything, but when we put a little color on there, beautiful things will happen. There. All right, ready to wash the old brush? That's the fun part. That's the fun part. Let's wash it. As you know, we wash our brushes with odorless paint thinner. Just scrub them off. Give it a good shake.
You
cover the entire studio. That's really the fun part of
it.
Now, sometimes when you're walking in the woods, which I do quite frequently, and you look out and you see the light coming through, it's so bright, it burns right through the tree. Watch. It's easier to show you. Take the brush. I'm just going to take one corner. Just one corner. It's a beautiful close-up there. One corner. And get a little titanium white on it. Now come up here. Decide where the sun's at back there, shining through all these trees. And very lightly, just begin that light area and begin working around. Notice that we're keeping that corner in the light spot. And we work around and around and around we go. There we are. See there? And begin blending outward. Now this paint is very opaque. We've used transparent color up until now. And now we're getting into opaque color. But that sun's burning through there. Light's just zinging right through. But by blending it out, it'll become transparent enough that you can still see the tree shadows through there. And that's what we're trying to achieve. To me, that's what it looks like when I see the sun shining through. There. You can still make out the images of the trees in there, but they're washed out. The same as if you're looking at them in the woods and the sun shining through. Just like that. And we can blend a little light right on down through here. Up to you. Up to you. You decide where it lives. You decide. There. Now you could do this several times to achieve a desired lightness or a desired brightness. This is about all that I want. I just want that nice, just spot shining through there strong. I like that when that happens. Okay. Actually, I just want to clean the brush again. All right, we're in business. Now we have to make some big decision. What's happening here in our world? Let's take some black and some Prussian blue. I'll be right back. I'm going to get a little crimson put in there too. Tell you what, maybe even a little sap green, a little brown, a little Van Dyke. Just all the dark colors, it doesn't matter. Okay, let's go up here. In my mind, I see back in here, maybe a little grassy area that lives right underneath these trees. So I'll just tap on a little dark. Don't need much because the black gesso has created most of it. We don't have to worry about it. Not like that. There. Just let it disappear back in there. Okay. same brush. We'll go right into some cad yellow, some yellow ochre. Let's just load some color on the brush here. Tap it, push it, give it a little. See that little ridge of paint right there? That's what we're looking for.
You can change the thickness, or not the thickness, what is it? Mixing level? Where is that? Settings? Yeah. We can turn this down if we just want to throw in this color. Let's do that. Oh, let's do that.
Come back with this beautiful green color and just begin tapping in the indication of some little grassy areas that live far away.
I imagine those are
far away. Away. Very soft. Very soft. There. Sneak them around some of those trees.
Maybe we don't want that.
There.
Let's use the paint brush.
Reload the brush as you need it. All right. But very gently. All you're doing is barely touching the canvas. Color shows up, it seems like 100 times better. Stronger on a black canvas than it does on a white canvas. It's amazing what happens to color. There. Wherever you want it to be. Wherever. Maybe a little projection sticks up right there.
Maybe not fast.
We can make a little bulb just by doing that. Whatever you want. You decide. I'm going to grab another 2-inch brush. I have several of them. Make sure it's good and dry. Small amount of titanium.
Maybe did that wrong. There we go. We can undo. The blue. Dump twice. Mixing sensitivity. And we can put this back in. That should get dark really fast. Yep, there we go. That's all I wanted.
Put color on here, even though it doesn't Doesn't look like it. There's a little bit of that blue that we put on. Very gently pull down. Don't put a lot of color on here. It shows up once again so bright. You need very, very little white to do this. Very little. And it's important that you pull it.
A little titanium white. I feel like last time I did this, it didn't work. What did I use last time? I used this one, Bristol, flat. And this one, I think, worked pretty well. Yeah. And then you can blend this down.
Just as easily I painted those trees with a gesso in the water and reflected them. I think in the last series or series before, I sort of lose track of them. I think we've done that. And it's gorgeous. You can do it. You can do it. Yeah, shoot, that worked pretty good. And go back and get some dark. That was black and blue and crimson, whatever. I want another one over here. I like that one so well. I'll just put us another little projection that comes right out through here. We'll add a little dark color in there. There. Okay, back into our yellow ochre, cadmium yellow. Once in a while I hit a little bright red, believe it or not. Red. We'll dull the color, because red and green make brown. So once in a while I had a little bit of the bright red. Sometimes you like to dull than to make things bright.
That's right.
Just begin forming this. Just begin working with it. Think about the layer of the land. Just put those little doubles in there. They're everywhere.
And blend out the purple.
There. But isn't that gesso just, it's one of the most fantastic ideas we've ever come up with. Color gessos are really wonderful. There. Don't know why we didn't do this a long time ago. It makes life so much easier when you're painting. And you can put things in like if you wanted to paint a little house or a building, you could do it all with the gesso. And then basically, all you need to do is just take it, put some clear over it, come back with a little color, and it's there. That quick. Take a little bit of the titanium white and put a touch of reflection into here. Just a touch. little too tight. Don't want a lot. I want to keep this pretty dark, so that light area back here really shines. There we go. About like it. And once again, just go across. Like this one. I think it's one of my favorite paintings in the whole series. And it's so easy. It's great for people who are just beginning to
get that white in. One more pressure. Try to fix this a bit. I'm sure there's a better brush for doing this.
Just beginning to experience the joy of painting. Hey, here's a commercial. All right, let's put some stones in there. We'll put some of these stones. I'm gonna take some black, a little Van Dyke brown, put it in there. Let's mix it up a little bit. A little dark sienna too. Okay, one more of your sienna. Okay, now we'll go over here and get some paint thinner. And I'm gonna thin this paint down until it's very thin. Our golden rule, a thin paint, we'll stick to a thick paint. We'll thin that down. There, that's good. That's good. Let me clean the knife. We'll take some white. We'll use a little dark sienna, a little Van Dyke brown. We'll make a highlight color for the rocks. Ooh, I like that. That's good. Not too bright. Okay. Do the same thing again. I'm going to thin this paint with paint thinner. So it's pretty thin. Pretty thin. It's about the consistency of soft face cream. Butter that you've left out. You know, sometimes you leave the butter out, it gets real soft and gooey. That's what we're looking for. Okay, let me clean off my knife. Probably the easiest way I've ever found of making very effective little stones is using a little filbert brush. Let's go through the dark color first, both sides. Okay, stay right there and I'll bring the light up. We have both sides full of dark. I'm going to take only one side and go through light. We have light, dark, light, dark. Now we can go back in here and you have to make big decisions. Where does all these little rocks and stones live in your world?
I mean,
you can put a million of them.
I don't even know how I'm going to do this. I don't have the tools. This isn't going to work. I don't think it's going to work. Nope. Spectacular. I'm not sure if that color on the camera, but a little, I don't
too. It's up to you. I like little stones, and this is the easiest way. There he is.
This is much harder without an actual filbert brush. Or a thinner of any kind, really. I mean, I have the thinner, but that just, that controls the, not what I want to control.
This is, but I know what to put them in. Maybe over here they're getting a little bigger. Big old rock. But in one stroke, you can put the top and the bottom of the rock in. That easy. Let's put some on the other side. We don't want him left out. There. Look at all those little rocks. Oh, I used to agonize over rocks trying to get them in there. Work myself to death. And you see how easy it is. If you want great big rocks, then use our little oval brush. Well, it just jumps right in there. I'm going to take a little liner brush, a little bit of white. Little blue in it, little halo blue in it, mostly white. Instead of using that, today I'm just going to take the liner brush.
Let's see what we can use here. This to make it even. I don't know, well, maybe a little bit, but not that much.
Just here and there, just sort of work a little water line right around the stones. I can't. Look at there. Just let it wander around. Wherever you want it.
Like where those ones are gory.
Wherever you want it. It just cleans up the edge in the bottom of these little rocks. There. Sit there, and they can come on out through here. There can be a few little things. You could do this with a knife if you want to. I thought today we'd just do it with a little knife.
Be pretty easy. You just take the brush number that we used before, but dunk it like 4 or 5 times. It should be almost completely transparent. Just like that. That's good enough. Maybe I messed up my mind, but that's fine. Oops. If you don't watch before most of my streams, you just go, whoops. Whoops.
But you need a thin paint.
I didn't put rocks over.
So it'll just zip right. After that, I think we use this one. White. This is what we. Oh no, we didn't do that. Change the old fixing thing down. Make some sensitivity. When you do yours, take your time and really feel like this. Really do it nice.
All the way down.
You're a little pressed for time there, so I have to do it a little quicker. But when you do it, just enjoy it. Enjoy it. All right. We got to put some on our foreground here. I just go back to our brush. It's got all the dark on it. We had blue and black and some brown.
Oh, well.
Let's see. Sap green, alizarin crimson. Bravery test.
Oh, he did our well.
He comes right across my cap.
It's too good for him not to.
There, just tap it in. Just tap it in. Fill it up. Fill it up. A lot of good dark color in there. Let's go into our yellow. Same thing as we did before. You just can do the same basic thing. Put some green here. By taking that color we had on the brush and going into yellow, automatically we get green. then we can begin just putting all kinds of grass and areas back in here. There they come. If you just take your time and you keep tapping this, it'll get so smooth you almost can't feel it. There. Nice little soft grassy areas. There they go. Right on out. There, more paint on the brush. Just keep working it back and forth, though. Something like it.
But we've got to turn down the sensitivity again. Otherwise, it just mixes too much. And we have to keep reloading the brush. It's very annoying.
Just sort of let your imagination go. Painting is so great because your imagination on a piece of canvas can become reality. Become reality. And sometimes we all need to escape from reality. But this is the place to do it. Here and there, where everything's peaceful and quiet. No bad thing. He's a happy place to see. Watch here. Sometimes, come right up in here. Sometimes it's fun. Take this brush, put it up here, and give it a little upward push. Watch. See that little grassy area?
It works pretty well. It's just like knocking on the door.
That's all there is to it. Got to make those noises or it doesn't work. There. Maybe the grass over here is a little taller. That's and you nice work grass. In layers. There. We go back to just tapping. Like that.
Works for me.
There.
I'm in the jet today.
And then they, whoop, yep, you're right. There's another, whoop, whoop, little glassy area right there. Wherever you want them. And over here, it's much softer.
Not every day has chat.
Much, much softer. Over here, so you want to take your shoes off and run through there with naked foot.
Okay.
That'd be fun. I like the feel of grass on the bottom of my feet with no shoes on. That gets a neat feeling. There. When we were kids, my brother Jim and I, we used to run all through the woods in Florida.
Could have brought some of them trees down a little bit.
And shoot, we were tough. We didn't even wear shoes back yet. Probably because we didn't have any. Oop. More little grassy areas. There. Just as many as you want. You know what we need? You know, don't you?
Tree.
We need a tree. Let's take some Van Dyke, a little dark sienna, mix them together with the old fan brush. And let's have a bravery test right now. Here we go. I'm on a tree that lives right there. Oh, right through the pretty rocks.
Tree. Oh, okay. This is perfect. Another back there. I can cover up that spot.
Just pull it through.
Oh, I can't. It's a
big, strong tree. Just keeps growing. You can always make them bigger. Sometimes you're some of gonna try to make them smaller. But you can always make them bigger. Put a big old easy foot on him out here so he has something to stand on.
Oh, I made mine off the camera.
There.
So that's okay.
Anyway, let's just use a little filbert. We'll take a little white, a little brown. And just,
interesting.
Just let that work right down the edge. That's too bright. I don't like that. Too bright. Let me darken it up a little. Too bright. Oh, that's much better. That's.
Let's do that. Not that big. Get some white for this. We'll start with this and then.
If you don't like something, change it.
In your world,
you have that kind of power. You can do anything. I get the impression the whole rough mean tree lives out here.
VR paintings I found.
There he is.
Do these in like 20,
we need some orange on our tree.
Regular
white things, hello.
But when I'm doing these.
Liner brush. There he is. Still the paint thinner. Van Dyke brown.
Correct.
There we go. In our world, there's an arm that lives on this tree. Right there. There he is. Got a few arms. Let's put some leaves on this tree so we don't have to put many arms. Maybe there's one that hangs off here that. There. Now let's put a few leaves.
I'm going over layers. I just turned the mixing off so I don't have to deal with it. Turning colors on.
Get a fan brush. Take some dark color, black, blue, maybe a little sap green and crimson in it too. And in our world, maybe push in a little dark first. There. I don't want to cover up all their trunk. Put something under it. There we go. Gives us an idea where some nice limbs are. I'm going to go right into the group. Yellow with that color since it had blue in it. Instant green. And push upward again. Sometimes we push down, sometimes upward. Get a little more color on here. Up to you. Up to you. There it comes. Trying to get too much busy here. Just enough to make this whole tree stand out. I'm still feeling crazy and I got a minute left. I like to do this because it upsets my director when we're getting low on time and I do something like maybe it's an old tree. Oh, fell. Thank you. fell down. This old tree just fell down. It was tired. It was a tired old tree. And I can relate to that. A little highlight along his edge here. Just using a little brown and white. Just Van Dyke Brown we made him with, just like the one standing up. This one, he's laying down on the job. Laying down on the job. That's okay. He had a long life. And now he wants to rest. We'll put a few old limbs that are still on here. Some coming out from the side and going out. There, if you had trouble making this slide, all you gotta do is just add a little more paint thinner to it. There, some old limbs are just... just hanging around out here. There we are. Go into a little bit of white, brown, like a lighter color. And we can
add some little tiny branches in there. Through the highlight, so it looks like it's fine. Pretty cool. That's how I make my branches look a little bit more natural. You got tips on how to do that. Mine are very interesting. My branch is not.
Highlight those a little, just so they stand out. Something like that.
Let's see if I can do this.
There. There, old trees just laying out there asleep. Now then. Let's go back and get our brush. It's got the dark color on it. I want a little bush living right here. So I'll put one in. Into your world. You put them in anywhere you want them. Put some dark in. Go into a little bit of light. I'm going to use a little into the yellow ochre side a little touch. Nah, I want more yellow ochre than that. If you're not happy with it, change it. That's better. I'm happy with it.
It's scratchy.
You can put these in anywhere that you want them. Just any old place.
Oops.
Just to make it look like there's a little bush right here on the edge. It goes right off the canvas. Happy little bush. Okay. Back to our little lighter brush. With a light brown color on it. And here and there and there. You can put in a stick or a twig. Just a couple. And we had rocks on the other side. Let me go back to my filbert. Had rock color on it. And maybe over here there's a rock or two that lives on this side. I know that side's better, but all the rocks didn't move over there. Still a couple here. Still a couple. Where did they live? Here's one right up against the tree. Yeah. Wherever you want. You decide.
I feel like this.
Right down here at the base of that big tree lives a little stone. You make the decision, but he may live right there. That's okay. Shoot, I think we got ready for a signature on this one. Here's a pink thing, a little bit of bright red, and we'll sign it. I have people write and I say, do you have to sign with red? Absolutely not. You sign with any color that you want. I've just sort of gotten in the habit of signing with red, and I always do it. It's sort of become a trademark. But you sign in any color that you want. There we are. I think we're going to call that one finished. Hope you've enjoyed it. I'd like to hear from you if you try this black and white and gray gesso, because it does fantastic things from all of us here. I'd like to wish you happy painting, and God bless, my friend.
Chat. Thanks for hanging out. I'll catch everybody. Oops. Just dropping things there. Catch everybody Sunday for an actual stream. Or in the studio, sorry. And then, yeah, might be off the next week, but I should be back the week after that. So, yeah, thanks for watching. Carry on.